context of this play. You've all received by now, I give up, two of these sheets. So that would be a good help to you. You'll notice it gives a little summary, as well as some things to think about. And I'll talk about what's on the sheet in a few minutes. But maybe just to begin by asking some questions, saying, well, most of you here have probably seen a play stage before live, yeah? So anyone here who's first time? Any first timers? Not yet? No? Nobody has been raised up to say it's a first time. You may find a few differences between this play and whatever plays you've seen before. Right? Well, what kind of, just begin by just asking, what kind of plays have you seen before? Yeah? Musical? High school musical? Yeah? That's where they got. Is it any good? Not high school musical.
I really need to tell anyone, you know, about
getting up or moving around or making too much noise during the drama, or, oh, you must behave yourselves. Because I think, honestly, one, you're not going to need that. And two, you know, you're old enough to know that, and you're experienced. But we won't need to be told that because, honestly, it's going to be so, okay, they always tell you to turn the cell phones off. They always tell you these little things. So do remember to do things like that. And if anybody does need the CR or to go early or something like that, just, you know, creep out quietly. Is that alright? Okay. Now, about the play itself. Let's move on to that. This is Champrey play in English. Some of the language you'll have to kind of get a little adjusted to. There will be some bad language, so anybody who's feeling, you know, queasy about that, it's too late now, you're stuck here, you'll have to get used to it. do appreciate this building in a peaceful way. And it's a bit like the tone between Rizal, who chooses to write and fight with a pen, or maybe the Bonifacios who say, you know, we've waited long enough, we want to take up the gun and fight Talagal, right? In Ireland, similar things happened. And maybe many of you know the name IRA, the Irish Republican Army. These people who decided we want to, you know, recognize that there is a war in Ireland, and we want to think of ourselves as engaged in an armed conflict to, you know, finally help the English to be persuaded to leave the country. A number of those people found themselves being arrested by the British government. Oh, what a surprise, isn't that? Okay, so a bit like the Spanish, you know, or the Americans, or the Japanese, arresting anyone here who were revolutionary, who would take arms against them. In Northern Ireland, they arrested people and they put them in particularly specially built prisons. At the time that this is set, in some ways, or at least on the flashing screen, you will see scenes taken from the actual prison of Irish Republican prisoners. During the early 70s, the Irish prisoners were treated almost as though they were prisoners of war. And the British government kind of accepted that these people were like soldiers of war, and that this was like an army, and they let them be in prison, they let them wear their own clothes, and they allowed them even to have, you know, their army drill practice, like ROTC, right? They let them have their own little talks and lectures, and they allowed them to call each other by kind of the army titles. And they allowed also, therefore, the captains in some ways to organize their own men and be responsible for their own men. So it was very much more perhaps like, you know, those prisoner of war films that you may have seen, you know, in World War II Germany and England, those sort of prisoner of war camps. That was until 1972 to about 1976. Around that time, something changed in English politics. Big change in English politics, and it's a name you may know again. Amongst the Conservative Party, Margaret Thatcher came to power. She's a wonderful lady in Ireland even today. We've got terrific memories of love and hate for this woman called Margaret Thatcher. Okay? One of the decisions made by her government was that this situation in Northern Ireland, where we respect them as soldiers and treat them as prisoners of war, that has to end. Today we're very used to the idea of war against terror. Now we're used to Bush and the Americanos talking about the war against terror. In some ways, it has its roots long before Bush, and it goes back to the